Hi, my name's John, and I design games. Now, from a game designer's point of view, I'd like to talk a little bit about God. You see, there's been a lot of talk recently about creationism and about the literal truth of the Bible, or the literal truth of the Quran, or the literal truth of the, you know, your holy book of choice. And as a game designer, I have particular issue with these, chiefly because most religions are kind of like games. If you look at, for example, the whole Christian tradition of heaven and hell, you can look at these as end game results. For example, when you die, you either go to heaven or hell. Now, these are conditions. You can look at them as win or lose conditions. Let's take the traditional argument that going to heaven is win, is the win condition, and going to hell is the losing condition. Right? Fair enough. Now, your life is the game. How you live your life, the choices you make, think of it like a Monopoly board. Going around the board, you land on a property, you decide whether to buy it or not. Or you think about Clue. You make decisions about which rooms you go to, and which weapons to pick up, and the guesses that you make, and the questions that you ask other people. And in the end of Clue, you only really get one guess, and if you get it wrong, then you lose, and you're out of the game. But how do you get to those winning and losing conditions? How do you win, and how do you lose? Well, as players of this game, we're instructed by a set of rules. In Monopoly, you read the rules. In Clue, you read the rules. In Trivial Pursuit, you read the rules. And if you play by the rules and you don't cheat, you, at the very least, have a chance of winning. If you play really, really well, you make the right decisions, you take advantage of opportunities, and chance doesn't screw you over too much, you can win. You have a chance of winning. However, if you make poor decisions and poor choices and you don't take advantage of chance when it's in your favor, or you know, minimize the loss when it's not, then you lose. Fair enough. Well, as a game designer, when I look at things like heaven and hell, win and lose, I have to think in terms of how do I want to win? Well, I'd have to look at the rules. And that's the problem. You see, we don't have a distinct set of rules. Now, as a game designer, when I give people rules for my games, I try my best to be as clear and concise as possible. That way it minimizes debate and discussion and miscommunication and misunderstanding about the rules, so people can play the game and not argue about it. And trust me, a lot of games that people, they spend 90% of the time arguing about the rules and 10% of the time actually playing the game. But, so as a game designer, I want my rules to be absolutely clear, absolutely concise, easy to understand. What set of rules has God given us for the heaven win condition and the hell lose condition? Did he give us a concise set of rules? Well, you could make the argument that the Bible is a concise set of rules, or the Quran, or the Book of Mormon, or, you know, L. Ron Hubbard's secret diary tapes, whatever you want to say. But there's a problem with this. Those rules are not concise. They're not clear. And, unfortunately, people spend 90% of the time arguing about what they mean, and 10% of the time actually playing the game. That's a problem. For example, here's a list of all the different translations of just the Bible. Yeah. So, the problem with that is that do we have a concise set of rules? Do we have a clear set of rules? Well, it depends on which set of rules you follow, really. And this is just the Christian Bible. If you want to compare the Christian Bible and the Jewish Bible, you'll find even more problems. The Bible did come, that Old Testament part did come from the Jews, and, well, they don't quite agree with the Christians' interpretation of their book, and so now we have a debate about which set of rules there is correct, and it's not very clear. So as a game designer, God, at least the God that put the book together, he didn't create a set of rules that's easy to follow. Now, again, you can make an argument that the set of rules are very easy. After all, there's 10 commandments. But which 10 commandments are you going to follow? Are you going to follow the first set that Moses brought down? Or are you going to follow the second set that Moses brought down? Or are you going to follow the other set of 10 commandments? Yeah, there's multiple versions of the 10 commandments. So, the question really becomes, did God, as a game designer, give us a clear and concise set of rules? Not really. And if there is a God, and it wanted us to have a specific set of rules, it'd be very easy to do. I mean, George Carlin did this bit, taking apart the Ten Commandments and boiling it down to be honest and true, and don't kill people. That's pretty easy. You know which one I like the most? This one here, the one about not seething a calf in its mother's milk, because, you know, that's really important. That's as important as don't kill, don't steal, don't rape. Hey, why isn't don't rape in here? And if you really, really want to follow the Bible as a set of rules for getting into heaven, and you believe that the Bible really is the unfettered, unalterable, uneditable, unscrew-upable rule, the rules that he gave us, then there's some other rules that you may want to pay attention to. Yeah, they're not pretty. But they're in the book. And they're the rules. And if these are God's rules, you don't screw around with them. Sure, if this was Monopoly, we could have house rules where, you know, if you have to pay income tax, you put the money on free parking, and anyone who lands on free parking gets the money. Yay, cool, house rules! But these are God's rules. You can't go screwing around with that. I have a lot of Christian friends who like to tell me that the Old Testament kind of got negated by the New Testament. That the New Testament, says that it's a whole brand new set of rules. Well, if that's true, if the Old Testament is the first edition and the New Testament is the second edition of the rules, why didn't God just give us the second edition first? I mean, he's God. He knows that rape is wrong. He knows that murder is wrong. He knows that theft is wrong. He knows all these things are wrong. And as a matter of fact, he knows what Jesus is going to say when he gets here. So why not just say that first? So as a game designer, I have to look at the world and the idea, the concept, that God gave us a set of rules and there's a winning condition and a losing condition. And frankly, that doesn't make a lot of sense to me as a game designer. I'm not a theologian, I'm not a biblical scholar or anything like that. I'm just a game designer. But if life is a game in that it has a winning condition and a losing condition, I would really like to know the rules. And unfortunately, none of my fellow players can agree on what those rules are. At least from the rule book itself. Just a thought. Thanks for listening.